change this community into what Martin Luther King's dream was. So make friends here today. We need each other. That's why I married her. She's sure sweet and to the point. There are two other people that you've got to know. When I look at the young people, we said this, not being disrespectful to anybody. We said the young people are going to lead this march. Because you're more than the future, you're very much right now. Do you hear what I'm talking about? And we wanted our young people to lead us because we know in Montgomery County, we have outstanding young people. You don't have to just make the newspaper with killing and stealing and dropping out of school. We have made it because you led us to this point. We love y'all and we are grateful. I want to recognize our youth leadership. This year we did something we've never done in previous years. We have a youth leadership team under the leadership of Matthew Cotton. Where's Matt? Come on up here, Matt. Come on up here, Matt. I want that hat too when you get off stage. Come on, bro. Matthew Cotton and Taylor McCory. Let's give it up for Matthew and Taylor. These are our youth leaders who really pulled this thing together and set up the youth workshops, all of that kind of stuff. Matt.
Thank you. Thank you everyone for coming. You know, I feel that this is not the beginning of working towards the dream. And you know, a lot of you friends have been doing this for, I'm sure, all your lives. And you know, really, I hope this day just serves as an impetus, and it's been really a pleasure to just be a part of a community to help coordinate these activities. So, thank you.
I just want to say I appreciate everybody coming out to support everything, and we have to remember that this is for Martin Luther King and to remember his dreams. So.
All right, let's give it up for our young folks. Now we're going to be back in the hands of my friend and my brother, and our host for this portion of things, Brother Big Mackie, Mackie, Shacky, Shacky. Let's give it up for the Shack Attack.
Hold on, right on. Y'all, let me just sit down, man. Show how y'all feel. We're gonna move expeditiously. I just need to hear real good. How do y'all feel? Hey, y'all give it up for a hype, man. Stand up, bro. Let me somewhere. He has a petition. Give it up for the group called True. Y'all give it up.
I was thinking about Dr. King's speech, I Have a Dream. And I was thinking, man, it's kind of felt like that dream died and we need to resurrect it. It's time to bring it back. And so I wrote this song, it's called Resurrection, and I hope you enjoy it. Here we go. The man that he was, his vision and dream. When I think about what he saw for the future, how he never lost hope that we'd all come together. I wonder if he could ever have imagined that progress would stall and we'd lose our ambition. I wonder if he thought after all this time we'd still have solutions we're trying to find. Do you think he dreamt of the crime in the streets or the battle among races there still seems to be? Do you think his vision involved guns and war, or is there a chance? You know he wanted more, more peace, more change, and more unity, more love between humans, more ways to be free. Today is the day we can breathe a new life, give hope to a vision that was a great life. So listen to me and pay close attention, cause today I'm proposing a new resurrection, y'all. Come on. Yeah, that's right. Yeah, Dr. King had a dream. All we need is a little bit of faith. We're gonna resurrect that dream today. Oh yeah, we're gonna watch it fly, y'all. Oh yeah. There is no time, it's better than now. To stand up today and show we know how. To just
Would not have been achieved without the wholehearted investment
of the people who fought every day. So, let us continue to follow his lead and actively oppose oppression and ill treatment of the others around us. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Evie Reyes. I'm originally from Beach, which I used to win third place in the MLK annual speech contest. So, most of all of our lives are determined by the checkpoints we pre-position for ourselves. You may study hard with the goal of having that high school diploma in your hand, or you may work hard with the goal of receiving that weekly paycheck. Whatever it is, we are always racing against time to get somewhere. For a moment today, we are allowed to think about Martin Luther King in his revolutionary speech. It took effect and it changed our world. But now what? We can't possibly sit still now. We owe it to the brave essence he left behind and the path he painfully carved for things to be easier for us to ask ourselves one very important question. Where do we go from here? Now, I couldn't possibly determine the right plan for the global community that we are a part of, but I can say this. We are living in one of the most admired countries in history, and for many reasons. We have set new highs for education, we have challenged the hardest of scientific ideas, and well, we've even gone to the moon. But I don't think that was what Dr. King aimed for when he pushed for progress. I think he was speaking about the unwritten rules by which we take every step. The rules that demand that we have enough conscience to treat each other with respect as the equal members that we are. So what do we have to overcome? One thing, the status quo. We have to be unexpectedly good at everything we do. We have to be awesome. We have to be the best. So that someday, the right people, the hardworking people of this country, rise to power. And we're no longer separated by borders and nations and governments, but that we are united as the united peoples of the world. It takes small steps to get there, and the successes of each one of us are the building blocks for the stairway. When we're there, we'll be able to address the problems that really exist. And it's impossible to say that we can't make a difference, because really, would you dive underwater so the rain won't get you wet? I think not.
We're moving expeditiously. I have a young man, Brother Colby. He's one of the more talented young people in our area. I want y'all to give it up for him. He got swag too, y'all. Give it up for him.
What's going on, everybody? What's going on? I saw everybody out there marching today. I'm proud of everyone, kids, adults, elders. I want to do two songs real quick. Let me give you a brief little intro to who I am. My name is Colby Ross. I was born here in Dayton, Ohio, born and raised. I love it here. I don't care where else I go. I got to come back home. But more importantly, I do music for a living, and I go under the name of Cole De Leon. I've traveled all over this country representing Dayton, Ohio, and let people know that there's good things coming out of Dayton. There's positive things coming out of Dayton, and we will make a change. So with that being said, I kind of want to give you a little story about where I got started. Let me give you a little story about where I got started. DJ, for lack of better words. This song is called Three Wishes. And if I could, I think you guys would catch on. I just need you to clap for me. We go like this.
I was only 14 when I first came.